Okay, what you see here is a Gatorade foil top on an inch and a half thick 2x4. To the right side is a gold 14K ring. Here's a bit of jewelry, gold 14K. And here's a gold tooth. Now, here's a nail bent into a V shape on the left side, foil cap in the middle. I have the Mirage set up to do some shallow gold ring hunting, going for the meat and potatoes. Now at an inch and a half we can hear that bent nail bouncing off the edge of the coil. If you pick it up just a little more, for instance, 3/4 of an inch more depth, and we don't hear that nail. So I've turned my threshold down and the Gatorade foil cap is not doing anything. This broken bit of a gold ring is silent as well. You're going to miss this kind of stuff. A gold crown you're missing, but the meat and potatoes, the ring, you know, I'm just shallow hunting. Here I'm not hearing that nail down there. Going over that at inch and a half plus 3/4 of an inch, you don't hear it. If you get down to inch and a half, it's going to bark on the edge of the coil. Gatorade top, you ain't going to hear. And the gold ring is at an inch and a half is sounding off in the middle of the coil as opposed to the nail, which is sounding off on the edge. But get a little bit above it and it's silent. Now, let's just put 3/4 inch over that. Still getting a good sound on that gold ring. But if you move that 3/4 board over the nail, you don't hear a thing. So that is quite interesting. And we'll put this here 3/4 of an inch over to the 2x4 plus another inch. And look at that gold ring. Still sounding off. So, if you're looking for the meat and potatoes, the Mirage is, can be set up to hunt for the meat and potatoes gold rings. I'm running the pulse delay at a solid 3. I got my threshold back into the silent range and my gain's at 5 and the sat's at 8. Pretty cool machine if you just want to find gold rings.